Navigating through water presents distinct challenges, requiring the human body to develop specialized adaptations. These adaptations are most visible in elite athletes who have dedicated their lives to aquatic sports, like China's Chen Haiyang and Sweden's Sarah Sjöström. Chen, a three-time gold medalist in the Aquatic Championships and the current world record holder in the 200-meter breaststroke, and Sjöström, an Olympic champion holding three world records, exemplify the heights of human athletic adaptation to water. The physical prowess they display, marked by extraordinary endurance, strength, and technique, stems from years of rigorous training and an inherent ability to move efficiently through water. Yet, as impressive as these athletic achievements are, they are still outmatched by the natural adaptations seen in the Bajau people of Southeast Asia. The Bajau, often called sea nomads, have lived on boats and in coastal communities for generations, relying on their ability to free dive for food and resources from the seafloor. Their unique way of life involves spending up to 60% of their waking hours in the water, leading to extraordinary physiological changes. The Bajau have developed larger spleens, approximately 50% larger than those of average humans, which allows them to store more oxygen-rich red blood cells. This adaptation is critical for their ability to hold their breath and dive to depths of up to 200 feet for extended periods, sometimes as long as 10 minutes. Furthermore, studies have shown that their lungs and diaphragm have undergone structural changes, enhancing their ability to withstand the pressures of deep diving. These adaptations are a striking example of how the human body can evolve in response to an aquatic environment, highlighting the incredible versatility and resilience of human physiology. If you find this information helpful, please like, subscribe, and turn all notifications on to stay updated with our latest fitness tips. While the Bajau represent an extreme case of adaptation, humanity as a whole has several traits that suggest a natural affinity for water. This observation has led some biologists to propose the aquatic ape theory, or the waterside hypothesis, which posits that many of the characteristics that make us uniquely human may have developed from a semi-aquatic lifestyle. According to this theory, certain human traits such as hairlessness, subcutaneous fat, and multipyramidal kidneys are more commonly found in aquatic or semi-aquatic animals than in other land-dwelling apes. For instance, humans are relatively hairless compared to our closest relatives, the great apes, but similar to aquatic mammals like dolphins and whales. This lack of body hair might have helped early humans reduce drag in the water, aiding in swimming and diving. Additionally, humans possess a layer of subcutaneous fat that serves multiple purposes, including insulation from cold water and increased buoyancy, much like the blubber found in marine mammals. This fat layer is absent in other great apes, suggesting that it may have developed in response to a life near or in the water. Another intriguing aspect of our biology is the structure of our kidneys. Humans have multipyramidal kidneys, which are efficient at filtering and excreting excess salt, an adaptation that could have been beneficial for early humans living in coastal environments and consuming a diet rich in seafood. This diet, high in omega-3 fatty acids like DHA, is crucial for brain development, supporting the idea that a coastal or aquatic lifestyle could have played a role in the evolution of our large, complex brains. One of the most compelling pieces of evidence supporting our connection to water is the behavior of human infants. Newborns exhibit the dive reflex, a survival mechanism where, upon contact with water, their heart rate slows, and they instinctively hold their breath. This reflex, combined with the ability of many infants to float on their backs, suggests an innate aquatic ability that might have been more pronounced in our ancestors. Whether or not our ancestors were truly semi-aquatic is still a topic of debate among scientists. However, it is clear that humans have a natural ability to adapt to water, which is reflected in the widespread enjoyment of aquatic activities and the numerous benefits associated with them. Swimming, for example, is not only a fun and relaxing activity, but also has profound mental and physical health benefits. Research has shown that swimming and other aquatic exercises can significantly improve mood, reduce symptoms of depression and anxiety, and enhance cognitive function, including memory and learning. The reasons behind these mental health benefits are not entirely understood, but they may be related to the soothing nature of water and the rhythmic, meditative quality of swimming. The physical benefits of aquatic exercise are also unique compared to land-based activities. Water provides 360-degree resistance, engaging multiple muscle groups simultaneously, which makes it an excellent full-body workout. The resistance offered by water during movement helps build strength without putting undue stress on the joints, making swimming an ideal exercise for rehabilitation and for individuals with joint pain or arthritis. The buoyancy of water supports the body, reducing the impact on bones and joints while still providing enough resistance to build muscle and improve cardiovascular health. Swimming is also one of the best exercises for improving cardiovascular fitness. It promotes angiogenesis, the formation of new blood vessels, which increases blood flow and oxygen delivery to muscles and organs. This process not only enhances athletic performance, but also aids in recovery and overall vitality. For individuals with exercise-induced asthma, swimming is often recommended as the ideal form of cardiovascular exercise. The humid environment around water can help ease breathing and reduce asthma symptoms, making it easier for individuals to maintain an active lifestyle. Beyond the health benefits, becoming a strong swimmer is a life-saving skill that can prevent drowning and other water-related accidents. Essential swimming skills include the ability to tread water and perform life-saving strokes like the side stroke. Treading water involves staying upright and afloat using minimal energy, a crucial skill for surviving in open water. The side stroke is particularly useful in rescue situations, allowing a swimmer to tow another person to safety while keeping both their heads above water. For those looking to improve their fitness or burn calories, different swimming strokes offer various benefits. The breaststroke is an excellent choice for beginners as it is relatively easy to learn and allows the swimmer to keep their head above water, making breathing more manageable. It also strengthens the legs, triceps, and upper back. The backstroke is another stroke that keeps the head above water and is especially beneficial for improving posture. It lengthens the spine, opens up the shoulders, and helps correct forward slouching. Freestyle, the fastest fitness enthusiasts practice shadow boxing and kickboxing in the water to build strength and endurance. Thank you for watching. Please share your thoughts on our video in the comment section below. If you found it enjoyable, we encourage you to share it with your social circle on Facebook, WhatsApp, and X as well.